Hello everybody and welcome back to another American Truck Simulator video. Today we're going from Wenatchee, Wyoming to Salmon, Idaho with 66,000 pounds of cows. It's 503 miles, 9.5 hours to get there. We'll be driving this Topanga 389. It's nighttime or morning time and you can't really see it, so but we will, I'll show it to you when the light sun comes up. All right, let's go ahead and get this thing started and hit the road. We've got a little drive ahead of us.
Turn right.
I've been using 1.51 beta version, so some of them crap might be all screwed up. Shouldn't have any problems. Should have enough fuel to get there. We got a full tank. Say 9 hours now. I thought it was only five. Tried using the my JVX graphics. Didn't end up good. Time was all screwed up. It's daytime. A bunch of it didn't run good. So we took it out. And PNG is not updated for 1.51, so we couldn't use it. It's got the C16 Caterpillar by Z miles. I threw 18 speed in the standard.
Turn right. Turn right.
So far, I haven't really had much problems out the 125 elevators. Seems to perform pretty good. It took me a little while to figure out how to work they call it the title screen now, but the profile screen is different. It's not that hard to figure it out. Comes the sun. Thing you could do is hit the damn brakes, let off of it, and let it just kind of glide through it. Stopped and waited until like 9, 10, the sun's higher up in the sky. Same thing with sunset, I'd wait. It started getting dark. It's a pain in the ass. Wait station, 1 mile. Rut road. Got 66,000 pounds on, we overweight.
Keep right.
Green light, bypass. Good deal. Thank you. brakes when you cross the state lines. A new physics mod, but in order to use it for modded trucks, you have to basically rewrite the whole freaking mod. I'm too damn lazy to do that. Don't even know how to do it. I should have stuck the C16 twin turbo in this thing. We're making, it should be 1,000 horsepower. She's doing pretty good going through these hills with 66,000 pounds. And 4.3 miles to a gallon. Train Station 75. Thing with this beta version of 1.51 is the gauges, they get that when the sun is behind you, they get that glare where it makes them all frosted, whatever you call it, white. That's a pretty easy fix. So. This game doesn't look too bad without the graphics mods. SSD drive. Put this game on it. That'll take care of a lot of the problems, I think. It'll run a lot better. That and plus Star Citizen. I have to have one for the game. They're pretty cheap, though. It's $100 for a terabyte. Product right. 2-4. GPS voices from Z-Mods too. I think my brother might have an SSD drive actually. He's always buying new computer parts.
And then turn right.
Always take his old ones.
Turn right.
big-ass storage vault somewhere. Can't turn up here. Now, most of the custom sound mods are from Zmod, except for the sound pack one. I spent too much money on this damn game. You want me to go down this way to this cab?
When possible, make a U-turn.
$5,172. Have to take a film. Gallon of diesel fuel weighs about 6 pounds. The gauges.
Turn left.
Keyboard. Alright, we're clean and green. Fast, you know, 113 miles to go. Seems to be putting a little turbo on his lawnmower. It didn't really help much. It'd make about 2 pounds of boost. Guess you can put a turbo on about anything. Thank you. scheduled for 2 p.m. now. Flatlands of Nebraska and Kansas, all the way up to Oregon, Washington, mountains and trees and forests. But I like the trees and forests better. Turn right, 10-4.
Turn right. You have arrived at your destination.
2 o'clock, right on the dot. Miles, 23 hours, 24 minutes. Damn, 23 hours. 15.6 gallons of fuel. We got $788,892. We're almost level 127. So, I hope you guys enjoyed the little trip we took. The next time, don't forget to
like, subscribe. Share and leave a comment down below. We'll see you in the next video. Have a great day.